So I just want to thank Sam for asking this question for today's video. He asked, what are effective ways to succeed in medical school? I think by asking this question, you're already that much closer to succeeding because it shows that you care about what you're getting yourself into. Personally, especially during the first and second years of your didactic years, it's very important to know what your core value is, because oftentimes during those first second years, you're going to get so bombarded with coursework and you're going to be fatigued. You're going to want to quit. And it's always important that you revisit what's the most important thing about choosing this career, so that every time you want to quit, you're reminded of why you're here. Now let's get into the nitty gritty of succeeding in medical school. I want you guys to think of medical school as a very big trivia game. So every bit of information that you're taught, you're going to want to somehow be able to recall, because at the end of the game, that is the name of the game. There are multiple ways of memorizing things. You can draw things out if you're a more visual person, like when you're drawing out things for anatomy per se. You can also make flashcards if, you know, revisiting material and quizzing yourself is the way to do it. So you can use Quizlet or Anki, A-N-K-I. It's another one of those resources that a lot of students use. You can also use your peers. So you can, you know, video chat them and just ask random questions and see if they can get them right. Or you can ask your peers to do the same thing for you and see if you can get them right. And that way you're both quizzing each other and you're both benefiting from it. Next, I want to tell you guys how to prioritize your time, because at Temple, there's many times where maybe you have a test on Monday and then you have another test on Wednesday, and it's Friday night and you don't know how you're supposed to study. Well, my suggestion would be, do not focus 100% of your time on just the Monday exam, because if you do that, because by Monday night, not only are you gonna have a ton of anxiety, you're gonna have a lot on your plate, because now you have Wednesday's exam to study for. So what I would recommend is study, like if it was Friday night, study 80% of Monday's material and 20% of Wednesday material. Or you can also alter that to however what your confidence level is. So if you're more confident, then maybe you can do 70% Monday's material, 30% Wednesday material, so that your burden just lightens up a little bit. It's like killing two birds with one stone. Easy, right? Next, being a big fan of Survivor, I can see a lot of similarities between the Survivor game show versus med school. So there are always those who go on an island and, you know, already know how to fish, how to build a shelter. And similarly in med school, there are people whose memories are just extraordinary. Like they can memorize things and, you know, regurgitate all the information that is required for them. So, you know, it's easier for them. But there are also those who are on island and cannot build a shelter, but they need the help of the group to build a shelter or a fire and stuff like that. And there are people in med school who need that extra assistance. So what I do recommend any freshman coming in is that you should seek out help from the upperclassmen or your peers, because they're gonna get help from their upperclassmen. One of the ways to succeed also is having the resources like back exams. So the upperclassmen are gonna have that. And it's up to you to, you know, reach out to them, because we're not just gonna give you guys things that we think you might need, because we don't know if you need it. You gotta ask us. So ask your peers, ask your upperclassmen, and you'll succeed. They're gonna give you a bunch of resources that you can use for your classes, your exams, and stuff like that. In conclusion, whether you're a class topper or someone who's just barely making it, there is a way to succeed. I have confidence in all my viewers, whether you comment on this video or not, whether you like this video or not, or whether you subscribe to this video or not. I have confidence in you. Until next time, peace.